All right, everybody, welcome back to another episode. I'm not going to do a whole lot of talking here at the start of this video. I just want to run through a brief on what we're doing. So, as y'all saw, we made it to the track last time, and this is going to be our second go. So, just kind of give you guys and gals a rundown on what's going on. So, currently, it's Friday. Testing 2 in Heartland is today, starting at gates open at 4. Testing starts at 5. We just pulled into Larry's here. We were trying to get some things done earlier this week, just didn't work out. As y'all know, the last time we were trying to get this thing to bump in, it wouldn't bump in. So we're gonna address that, and then we're gonna just look over everything from a suspension perspective, make sure that everything is set up, check the alignment, so on and so forth, make sure everything's happy, make sure when we get it there, it's going to as straight as possible without knowing exactly what it's gonna do. So that's where we're at right now. Hopefully everything goes smooth. I think right now it's working on 10 o'clock, so got a little bit to do before we get there. Yeah, hopefully everything will go good. Last Sunday, I got everything put back together and where I thought it needed to be, and started the car. Wanted to take it for just a little cruise just to make sure that everything was happy, and sure enough, I lost everything. I couldn't put it in gear. So long story short, I went through a few things, drained the fluid, went back and checked to make sure that everything was happy. And put it all back together and check converter pressure, transmission pressure, and it was all working fine. I have no idea what the heck was going on. The converter obviously drained all the fluid out of it, or I shouldn't say obviously, but drained the fluid out, and you know, it's something that can happen, but it's working, and hopefully it'll still be working here in a few minutes. But probably won't video a whole lot of that. I'm gonna do the best we can to video. It's just Dad, myself, and Larry, so main focus is a car, but we'll do the best we can. So that's where we're at, and we're excited to have you. Like, subscribe, share, all the good stuff. We greatly appreciate y'all, and we're looking forward to this one. Say a quick prayer for us. Hopefully everything goes smooth and we're able to be safe today, and the good Lord's gonna be with us and watch over us and guide us through this journey. So we're super excited for round two. Let's go. So if you can't already tell, we did not make it to the track. So honestly, just being 100% transparent, it didn't feel right. We were trying to sneak everything in and make it all work out. And Larry had a lot going on. He was trying to get a couple cars out the door in between a couple weeks of racing and a lot of travel. So we would have been rushing, and not everything was 100% right. We're still dealing with some shifter issues and stuff like that. We actually never did get around to bumping the car in. Did get around to running through everything from a suspension perspective, and we put it on scales and everything like that. Everything seems to be set up for, I guess, more of a baseline than anything to go out and make a test. So everything seems to have been set up correctly, which is good. And we're glad we could set that up on our own and get everything right and know what adjustments kind of need to be made depending on what the car does. For the most part, obviously, we're going to learn as we go, as we progress, and the more we experience it. But I was able to also get it on scales, and the car, without me in it, came in just under 2,500 pounds. Like I said, Larry's usually not open on Fridays anyways, and he had all his guys in there and people rolling in the door. And he was trying to get a couple cars out the door. Yes, we could have gone on our own, but I really just still don't want to go without somebody there with us for the first main voyage. But either way, we did resolve the shifter problem actually that day when we got it back to my place. So we got that resolved, and today we're gonna go ahead and see if we can't get it to bump in and figure out a couple other things. So the main thing is just making sure that the car is bumping in the way that it needs to. It's not too aggressive, not too light. Right now it's obviously too light because it wouldn't bump at all. So we're gonna mess with that a little bit, get that figured out, And then the last thing that I'll note here is we're not 100% sure, so we're already rolling into October here, and the first thing is that there's got a lot of races coming up, so that's one thing. And then two, just, you know, kind of getting this close to the end of the season, there's not a lot of opportunities to go test. So not only are we fighting the battle of finding somewhere to go test without having to travel across the country, we're trying to fit it in with his schedule. So everything's got to kind of work out perfect. So I don't know. Hopefully we'll get the chance. If we don't, we don't. And you know, we'll go back to the drawing board and fix a couple things that we need to address and get everything right for next year. We might have an opportunity on a Wednesday something there at Worldwide Technology Center, which previously known as Gateway, there in St. Louis area. So they got like 3 test and tunes on a Wednesday towards the end of October into the start of November. So we might be able to maybe take a day off and scram that way if it all works out. But if not, once again, we're just going to go back and finalize some things and get it figured out for next year. And then hopefully we can roll into next year with a clean slate and go in there with everything happy. You know, it's a race car world, so you never know. Things come up by the minute. So we'll see what happens. But either way, that's where we're at. We're going to see if we can't get this thing bumped in. I'll try to do a little video on. So stay tuned. And yeah, we're excited to have you.
Solenoid out, or the relay out of it, or anything?
The only thing that's unplugged is that one that I had that was getting hot on me. but I thought that was for the lockup.
So it was that one cylinder, right?
Right.
Yeah, let me jump in there and go over on the other side.
I guess I just got scared after that last time when I lost everything, so I just put it on the screen.
I get it.
That I was kind of letting off on, it just kind of hurt. It's holding, but it ain't fully holding. I can feel it slowing it down, but it ain't stopping. All right, so I messed up big time. The one time that everything worked, I didn't get out of the car and press record. So as y'all could see, we're trying to put it on step. Trans brake wasn't holding. For some reason, looking at the log, it was showing just say X pressure, and it was dropping like 60 pounds just sitting at idle. So I was trying to hold, but obviously there wasn't enough pressure to hold the car. So don't know why it's doing that. Gonna make some phone calls this week, but either way, I made the mistake of not pressing record when we fired it up one more time just to see what it was showing on the computer, and sure enough it actually held. So we just went ahead and bumped in perfect the first time. And the one reason I am happy that I didn't press record is because I made the silliest mistake of not letting off the throttle. I was super excited that it bumped in, and I just let go of the trans brake. So car took off in the driveway, left a couple of black marks. But either way, the good news is brakes work, the bump works, trans brake, got to figure out what the heck's going on there. Don't know if we have something hanging. Not sure. And the filter's on, I'm like 99.9% sure. So it can't be that, but either way, I'm hoping, and I truly think it's got to be something minor, but either way, I wished I had it on video because it would have been a funny blooper. Car hooked pretty good though, right here in the driveway, I will say. And it was only on 11 pounds of boost, but still let go, and I had the car stopped by right here, so it's pretty good. So the brakes are working plenty good. So either way, the goal is, and you know, could be summing this video up right here right now, I'm not 100% sure, but the goal is, I just spoke with Larry, the goal is on the 18th of October to catch Gateway Worldwide Technology Center and see what happens. Obviously I'm gonna have to figure out what the heck's going on with trans brake and while we're losing pressure there at random. So hopefully it's a small fix, hopefully it's a quick and easy fix, but we got to get that lined out, get that figured out, and we will do so. So we hope that this isn't a conclusion of the video, but if it is, we're blessed to have you guys. Thanks for tuning in. I know it wasn't a lot, but we're inching a little bit closer and closer and closer. Honestly, if we don't make it out October 18th, we're probably just going to take this thing back to the shop, start breaking down headers, rebuilding the headers, getting everything set up and ready and happy. And, you know, that might be the safest route. It's not going to hurt anything to go make an attempt, but we also don't want to rush it. So we've already taken this long, and this project's been an ongoing one. So it is what it is. We want to err on the safe side of caution, and that's going to be our route. Well, she's up on jack stands. Unfortunately, this video might be turning into a fix-it video. We're dropping transmission pressure and added more fluid that didn't resolve anything. So I went ahead and drained the fluid, dropped the pan, and sure enough, there was some real fine black flakes stuck to the magnet on the pan. So I'm guessing the pump is having some issues. I wasn't able to get a hold of Carl at Rosner, but I'm gonna go ahead and start tearing this thing down. It's gonna be pretty tough on my own here in the garage, but I don't think I'm gonna have any value add by taking it back to the shop, and that 18th day to getting ready for test is probably not gonna happen. Just kind of tough to get back there and work on things. Either way, drain the fluid. Got the belly pan, floor pan out from underneath it. Gonna pull the shifter, take the tunnel out, or unhook the tunnel, remove the drive shaft, start unhooking this thing, and see what I can do. I have no idea, nor does anybody. Larry's not sure, Carl's not sure why, if it is the pump that this thing's having issues. As you all know, we've only done one burnout in a real small, I mean, probably 15-foot hit. So yeah, we put it on the step a couple times and just obviously officially bumped it in earlier this week, but I just don't understand why the pump would be having issues. So either way, we can only up from here. So we're gonna get this thing out. The converter just to double check, hoping that everything was fine, and everything, unless I'm crazy, looks as it should be. I'm no converter expert, I'm no transmission expert by any means. You know, I've built transmission, I've worked on them, have installed converters, but this is actually the first one that I've personally taken apart. But everything looks good. All the bearings are spinning great. There is some flakes in the corner. That's the same thing that I found on the pan, as you guys saw in the picture. Some more there from the pump as well, I'd imagine. But man, everything looks good. The only thing that I did discover, I found this little metal piece inside bottom of the converter here, but I do know what it came from. So originally when I pulled the converter, this hub here, you can see some of the little metal. If I can get that to clear up there, you can see some of the very edge of it kind of peeled back. I could be wrong, but my guess is obviously that the converter was up in there a little bit too far, which doesn't make any sense because, you know, I had my 3/16 inch clearance when I installed it, and I don't know. So we're going to have to go back to the drawing board. I'm going to reach out to Rosser, see what they got to say. I don't know if maybe, you know, the pump was damaged and it caused this or what. You know, after it was damaged, I guess that could be the case, but it's kind of baffling. But the good news is, in my mind, I don't believe I have any problems with the converter. So we're not having two problems. We just currently still have the one. So we'll keep dissecting. Probably just going to send the whole transmission over to Rosser and just make it quick and easy. I know it's going to be more of an expense, but better safe than sorry. So kind of go from there. I'm going to put this thing back together. All right, so I'm not going to speak a whole lot, but obviously you guys can see we got the transmission back and obviously the converter as well, but today is the 18th. So as mentioned, today was going to be the day that we were going to go test. And yes, it came in, it got to our warehouse yesterday evening, but I'm gonna tell you right now, with the couple troubles that we've had with it, we could get it done, we could get it in, we could probably get it to the track, but I'm not willing to rush it. It's not worth it to me. So we're gonna get this thing back in there, and then we're gonna take it stride for stride. I'm gonna go through kind of what we're gonna be doing to this thing, but we're probably just gonna count our cards and just get everything right for next year. Stay tuned. We're going to throw this thing back in. Not going to throw it in. We're going to do it right. I'm going to make sure everything's happy. And then we'll get back with you. The converter's in. I felt the three clicks. I'm sitting at about, from here, I put a flat bar across the end of the bell, measure back to these little cleats here on this spacer, on the back side of the converter, or the front side, whatever you want to consider it. I'm setting at about three quarters of an inch right here. So yes, there is a smidget of a gap between the block and the mid plate. Quarter inch mid plate, it's not much of a gap. I'm talking a hair. If I tightened it up, I took my measurements, I'm sitting at exactly 3/16. So hang tight. We're gonna do a little time lapse, getting this thing back in there, and then I'll get up under there and we'll check our gaps. We'll tighten the transmission in, we'll tighten and pull the motor back all the way, and then we'll check our spacing between the flex plate and the back of the converter. So we should be at 1/8 to 3/16, and I think that's where we're at. We'll be right back. So, it's a couple days later. As y'all saw in the video, we got the transmission in. Off camera, I buttoned up a couple other things. Threw the bolts in the mid plate and the bell housing. Went ahead and thrown the tunnel in there. Tidied some stuff up to get it kind of out of the way. Put all the sensors back in. Ran the wiring and the plumbing. Put the shifter on. We still have yet to put the drive shaft in. What I'm probably going to do, obviously, one thing I'm going to do, I'm going to show y'all on camera, is I'm going to get up underneath there and I'm going to show the clearance that I have between the flex plate and the converter. So I've measured with three different tape measures just to verify and ensure that I got that spacing, and I'm looking right at 3/16 of an inch. I'm going to put the converter bolts in, put the Loctite on them, torque them down, all that good stuff. Like I said, I'm going to show you all the spacing first before I go into that. After that, I'm going to get the car outside. Probably going to jack up the rear end, obviously, when weather permits. And I'm just going to go through the gears, make sure that it goes into gear. Everything's happy there. I'm going to check the pressure, converter pressure and transmission pressure on my ECU. Once we do that, I'm going to hop on to the laptop and then show you guys, you know, what I was reading for pressure originally. And hopefully, if everything's reading right, what I'm reading for pressure now. So I'll show you all the spacing, and then I'm gonna get to work on tightening that converter up and getting the drive shaft in there. So if that doesn't read 3/16, I don't know what does. So if I can keep the tape straight, I mean, it is money on 3/16. So, and you check all these little cleats if you go all the way around here. Like I said, I grabbed the wrong tape to get this on video, but every single one of them, I mean, it's money on 3/16. Obviously, you know, with this tape, it's kind of hard to read, but that big mark there is the quarter mark. Obviously, you can see the half mark, so we're setting right on 3/16. So I'm going to push this thing back, going to line it up, start throwing bolts in this bad boy.
look how cute we are.
So y'all saw it first. Everything seemed to work. Everything went into gear, went into reverse. So first, second, third, we had everything. As I stated, went in reverse. You guys saw it there on the video. I did have a little bit of a catastrophic situation there for a second. I didn't have one of the fittings tightened on all the way. I thought I double checked everything, but I guess I didn't. And that's why you test stuff. So I ended up having training fluid everywhere inside the car. I apologize for the kiddo. But either way, got all that cleaned up, retested, and seemed to have pressure the majority of the time. It actually dropped just for a second in there, and I'm not exactly sure why that is. I'm going to have to reach out and ask that question, but I'll pull it up on the computer, and hopefully next time, you know, we can, I'll test this off camera, obviously, one more time before I start breaking this thing down. And see what's going on. But let's jump over here to the computer now, and I'll kind of show you the differences. So here it is. I've got a few different logs pulled up, as you can see up here. What I did was I just pulled up the RPM and I closed all the other readings and we had on, just so we can narrow it down to the trans pressure, and then obviously based off of what RPM we're setting at that specific time. Once again, I am super green with all this stuff, so I'm not the greatest here, but we got a few different logs that I have pulled up, and you can see here just the pressure is super low. So this is the complete run down here. I will advance this out, but we had decent pressure here. I mean, you know, 90 to 100 up and down, but it's really finicky. And then after a while, RPM obviously advanced and went up there, and then it just dropped, and now we're sitting at 60 pounds, down to 30, and then it looks like it's all, it even gets down into, I mean, it's really low over here. It's pretty obvious though. Same here, let's advance this out for the complete log. So same thing. Up and down, and then it just drops again. And then go on to a couple days later, very similar. So this one's just really rapid, and then it just drops. And on to yesterday's log. This again, you know, it did drop here, and I don't know what that is. It'd have been virtually anything. I'm wondering if this is when I'm guessing probably when I put it in gear, put it in reverse and everything like that. So that was that. It did drop down, but wait, just for a brief second, and then the pressures went back up again. So that's great. Stayed steady. And then throughout the run, let's see, what else did I do? I'm guessing that's probably when I put it in reverse to drive it into the garage. Dropped a couple times there, but either way, pressures look a lot better. I'm gonna go ask those questions. Like I said, I'm gonna run it again, but yeah, happy with it, and we'll test it one more time. So as y'all could see, obviously, you know, things look a lot better than they did, than they were. But either way, you know, hoping for the best there on that one. And I'm going to ask some questions, like I said, off camera later on before I go breaking this thing down. I'm going to run it again sometime this week and just double check everything to make sure it's all right. But, you know, it is. It's a bummer. Winter is here, and we've had some cold days already. Obviously, racing season's pretty well over. You know, we'll get geared up and ready to rock and roll for next year, and I'm gonna tell you right now, it's got to work. This is a blessing, because if we would have went out and tested this car, it would have done some damage. So obviously, you know, converter went in the pump, damaged the pump, and it was actually starting to wear on the gear. So you know, it was gonna do quite a bit more damage. So, man, it is so cool to see God at work, and he was watching over us and just ensured that we didn't do any more damage to this thing, which was a blessing. Yeah, it kind of stinks that we didn't get to get it out, but you know, that's a part of it. And the coolest thing about it is that we're learning. So, man, it's just such a blessing. God is so good, and he works in so many different ways. Even when they seem rough, he's always working, it's a true testament. It just goes to show you right there, perfect example. So, either way, we're going to get this thing cleaned up and do some of that turbo work on it. We're going to roll some more videos out. We got some Corvette content here and there we're going to do. Obviously, I'll show everybody the new header design as we're working on that, getting all that ready to rock and roll. Hopefully you won't hear from me again about this transmission, because that means everything is okay and everything's happy. So that's where we're at. And man, we are so blessed to have y'all. Like always, it's so appreciated. And for those of you who are new or just popping in, please, please, please help us out. Hit that subscribe button. It's super easy. You just got to hit that little red box down in your bottom right hand corner of your screen. Subscribe. If you enjoy the video, if you appreciate it, stay tuned. We've got some cool stuff coming. We'll get better at these videos, but don't forget to like, share, all the good amenities. So we appreciate you. Can't wait to see you on the next one. God bless.